Ven's planet was once a peaceful place, a utopia never seen before in the entire galaxy. Its people were occupied mainly with cultivating their land, living their lives in harmony with nature. Each day was peaceful and full of joy. But one day, everything changed. Invaders from space came out of nowhere, determined to enslave the local population and to exploit the planet. The locals couldn't do anything but run and hide. Ven, in his effort to draw the invaders away from his younger companions, made the attackers chase him to the edge of a cliff. He had only two options, to get caught or to jump. And that leap of faith was the first step on his journey. He woke up in total darkness. After many hours, which felt like days, Ven eventually climbed up the hill and found an abandoned workshop. Once sheltered there, he made a thing that his people thought long useless in their daily lives, a weapon. The two swords Ven made quickly became extensions of his arms. He trained relentlessly, preparing his body for the challenges to come. When he was ready, there was one last thing to do. Ven walked into a maelstrom of noon energy, which gave him strength, new vitality, and magic power. Suddenly, he was disturbed by a weird noise. Ven threw his sword at the intruder, but luckily missed. The source of the noise was Terami, who showed him one of the young ones he managed to save. Ven realized that the friendly robot was different from the invaders. He found an ally to aid him in his battle. And now, it's time for him to meet you. You have arrived, initiating the awakening sequence. The planet Aspris can be seen from the cockpit. According to our headquarters' secret databanks, it is a peaceful planet full of life. All this is possible thanks to a special energy stored in local runes. These runes are the source of longevity of everything on the planet. Here, you don't grow old, but stay healthy for hundreds of years. This is probably why Bruce Nelson has come here, to collect runes and enslave the planet's indigenous population. Ven is waiting for you in the training section. Good luck.
Hey!
All Ven movements can be controlled by the left analog stick. To navigate through Ven's world, you will need to jump over various obstacles. Press the highlighted button on the right controller now to do so. There's a checkpoint ahead of you. You have to activate it using the attack button on the right controller. Perfect. Here you will learn how to jump over various obstacles to proceed further. Remember everything I have told you earlier, and you will be fine. These training bots are here to help you master Ven's fighting skills. Use the double jump and hold attack button to activate Ven's power attack and destroy four of them. These training vaults are here to help you master Ven's fighting skills. Use the double jump and hold attack button to activate Ven's power attack and destroy four of them. These training bots are here to help you master Ven's fighting skills. Use the double jump and hold attack button to activate Ven's power attack and destroy four of them. These training bots are here to help you master Ven's fighting skills. Use the double jump and hold attack button to activate Ven's power attack and destroy four of them. These training bots are here to help you master Ven's fighting skills. Use the double jump and hold attack button to activate Ven's power attack and destroy four of them. Remember that there are Ven's folks hiding from Nelson's minions in each level, and they will need your help. It's enough to help Ven reach them. He'll take care of the rest. First things first. The watches on your left-hand side will show the number of Ikai you've managed to save. The little screen below shows the number of Ven's remaining lives. When you collect runes, the screen fills up. Once it's filled up, Ven gets another life. The watches on your right-hand side will show the amount of time in the time trial mode and the number of chests collected. The middle screen shows you the most important information, such as the area you're currently in, the amount of the saved little Vens, and the time that it has taken you to finish the level. Selecting the area and starting its exploration is very simple. Use these buttons to choose the mission you want to go for, and then start the mission by moving the lever. If you want to change any settings, use the tablet. If everything is clear, let's send both of you on your journey. Pull the lever whenever you're ready. Once the main transshipment port of Aspyrus, Nelson left his robots there, ordering them to collect anything that could be of use later. Keep your eyes open and remember that Ikais could be hiding anywhere. Come on.
Thank you.
Job. My scanner has detected Nelson's ship. We're on our way there. Nobody knows what this madman has left behind to slow us down. We hope that our vertical slice was enjoyable and your shared adventure with Ven helped you enjoy some of your free time. If you have any suggestions or ideas, feel free to let us know. We're on the post. In this jungle, you will find many obstacles which will require some skill to overcome. I hope both of you are up for the challenge. Keep your eyes peeled for little Ikai escapees. I have detected some hiding nearby.
huh?
I see you get some, huh? But it's all for nothing. No one can stop me.
An interesting place. Unfortunately, I have no information about it. Be careful and watch your step.
Thank you.
Let's go back to the ship. We hope that our vertical slice was enjoyable and your shared adventure with Ven helped you enjoy some of your free time. If you have any suggestions or ideas, feel free to let us know.